In 1992, French schoolmates Guy-Manuel de Eumont Christo and Thomas Bangalter joined forces with Lorne Brankovitz, now member of the band Phoenix, to form the rock band Darling. A single of the same name was released but earned a lot of criticism in the UK. The magazine Melody Maker called the band a bunch of Daft Punk. In 1993, Bankiewicz left the band after only 4 songs. Still, the harsh critic would provide Eumont Christo and Bangalter with the title for their next project, Daft Punk. The duo started to explore electronic music. In 1994, they sent a demo tape to Soma Records, earning them a record deal with the label. The commercial success of the first single release, The New Wave, was rather limited. This should change dramatically with its successor. Daft Punk sold approximately 30,000 copies. The following songs have been Assault, Alive, and Rollin' and Scratchin'. Daft Punk made a name for themselves in the British underground scene, playing at several festivals and other occasions. Their hard avant-garde sound soon raised the interest of other labels. In 1996, Virgin Records signed the group. The contract stated that no photos of Eumont Christo and Bangalter should be released in order to fulfill their desire to stay anonymous. Daft Punk was re-released along with the video by Michael Gondry.
Yo, that's a good song!
Oh, thanks!
The first studio album Homework was released in 1997. It featured 16 songs, most of them old Soma releases.
The sound of tomorrow, the music of today, brings you exclusively Daft Punk's Homework.
The title derives from the fact that the album was recorded in Bangalter's bedroom. The record combined techno house and rave elements and was highly influential on French and ultimately global house music. Songs like Revolution 909, Burnin', Around the World and others were responsible for the huge success. Homework sold over 1.7 million copies worldwide, receiving platinum in France and gold in the UK. The band was able to combine commercial success with their ongoing high standing in the club scene. In 1997, the duo embarked on their first world tour. After that, the two took a break from Daft Punk to pursue solo projects. Thomas launched his own label called Roulet and released the highly successful single Music Sounds Better With You as part of the project Stardust. In 1999, the DVD DAFT, a story about dogs, androids, firemen and tomatoes was released. It featured all previous music videos.
Hey mister! The sea! You can hear the sea!
Hey, you really can!
We'll be right back. the end of the year 2000, the group finally made headlines again. Their single One More Time received extended airplay all over the world and sold far over 4 million copies, becoming their biggest commercial success to date. One more time. It reached number 1 in France and number 2 in the UK. For the first time, a Daft Punk song featured a complex arrangement of lyrics and melody. Their second album, Discovery, was released in March 2001. It combined disco, pop and synth elements while implementing samples from the 70s and 80s. Furthermore, Daft Punk used emotional vocals and harmonies on the record. Guy-Manuel and Thomas remained true to their revolutionary spirit, exploring new dimensions with each new project. The promotion of the record was accompanied by a marketing campaign of never-before-seen proportions for a house album. The two also changed their media appearance. They started to wear robot costumes, to which they hold the copyright, produced by the US company LED Effects. The masks soon became powerful signature features of Daft Punk. Musically, the album draws on the style of One More Time. Besides the likable sounds of Digital Love, and Something About Us. I might not be the right one, but there's something about us I want to say. The record also features dance floor materials such as Creston Dolls or Superheroes. Harder, Better, Faster, Stronger and Short Circuit reminded of past homework successes. The main part of the melody is taken from a funk disco track, electronically enhanced and adapted to the composition. The reoccurring loop in Superheroes is nothing else than a segment of Who's Been Sleeping in My Bed, written by Barry Manilow. In contrast to Homework, Discovery featured several collaborations with friends and fellow artists like Todd Edwards, Romanthony, or DJ Sneak. In September 2002, Daft Punk released their first live album called Alive 1997, presenting a gig in Birmingham. Nine months later, the duo debuted at the prestigious film festival in Cannes with their first motion picture, Interstellar 5555. Declared as an animated house musical, the film tells the story of four musicians from a foreign galaxy who are kidnapped and brought to the planet Earth by an evil manager. He turns them into the most famous band on Earth. The public already received a first glance at the film in 2000 and 2001. The music videos of the single releases One More Time, Aerodynamic, Digital Love, Harder, Better, Faster, Stronger and Something About Us combined for 15 minutes of the film. Interstellar 5555 covers all 14 songs of Discovery, each one receiving a clip. Daft Punk were able to hire their childhood hero Lei Matsumoto as the director while the two worked as co-producers. The enormous success of Homework, 2 million copies, and Discovery, 2.6 million, led to several endorsement deals, including a spot for Gap. I had a dream In June 2004, Guy-Manuel and Thomas created a remix of Take Me Out by Scottish rock band Franz Ferdinand. In 2003, the duo released a compilation called Daft Club, featuring pieces of Discovery songs.